Hi everyone, my name is Soodabeh and I am a freelance illustrator and icon designer. Welcome back. Today I am going to show you my process of designing an icon from start to finish. Let's go through all 5 steps one by one. As with any design project, make sure you know your subject. You have to think of your icon like a character. Is it meant for a children's app, a university, or a company? Your design needs to convey that. Your icon is also a metaphor. If you need to create an icon that represents the object itself, it's fairly easy. But what if you need to create an icon that represents meaning, a verb, or a noun? As it is harder to convey, I suggest you just Google a word for inspiration. For example, here I made an icon that represents multitasking or routine that doesn't have a defined shape in reality. But with mixing the elements that represent this meaning, you can make an icon that conveys these words. You can also get inspired by looking into icon packs that other creators made. I personally use Icon Finder as a reference, and also this is where I have my portfolio. Designing icons is actually so much fun, and you have many styles to choose from. First, we have outline icons versus filled-in icons. Here is a glyph icon, which is filled-in with a solid color. Flat icons, as the name suggests, represent flat design principles, in the sense that they have minimal to no shading, shadows, or gradients. 3D icons that are so on trend these days are on the other hand. They are designed to imitate their real-life counterparts. And finally, you can also opt for hand-drawn icons. But essentially, if you are a beginner, I suggest you start with outline icons and develop your style from there. You also need to define your color palette at this stage. I made a whole video on creating unique color palettes in Vectornator that you can check it out in the link below. All complex designs start with simple shapes. So the first step to design an icon is to break it down to simple shapes. As you see here, the ice cream is made of ovals and rectangles. Before vectorizing your icon, it's better to have a sketch as a reference. After checking some photos to get inspired, I usually start with a simple sketch in my sketchbook or Procreate app. Also, I've already decided on the colors that I want to use. This is my palette right here. I've chosen some cold colors to represent the ice cream that I think will match the theme of my series. Now that I imported my sketch in Vectornator, I can work with vectors. First, I'm going to create a new layer. And before I start drawing, a very important step is setting up my grid, which I will do by creating a square, adding margins, and then drawing the lines of symmetry. A grid is essential when you are designing an icon pack. Keep in mind that all icons need to have the same height and width. And it's especially needed when designing for platforms like iOS or Android that have a predetermined grid size. To make it easier for you, we will include the most standard grid dimensions and this grid template in the description box below, so you have them all handy. Now that I have my grid and guides, let's start creating vectors. Just like before, I am just going to draw the same shapes on top of my sketch. To create these shapes, I go to the shape tool, select what I need, and then I will place all my shapes on top of the sketch and adjust as needed. While I work on these shapes, I've talked to you about some important principles. First of all, you need to give your icon a personality. There are so many different icon packs out there, so the best way to stand out as an artist is to have your own drawing style or a unique color palette. Secondly, as you are designing an icon, it needs to convey its message at one glance. It cannot be too abstract or too complex, because otherwise it will lose its meaning. This also applies to its composition. Try not to get too much into detail. Your icons should be readable at any size, big or small. And lastly, if you are designing an icon pack, make sure that all your icons have the same properties, like the same line weight, the same general color palette, similar edges, curves, and corners, and an overall similar style. Okay, now back to my drawing. When I am creating the cream on top of my ice cream, as it is not a defined shape, I will be using the pen tool. I start my path here. Click and drag until I'm happy with their position. And then tap again here and repeat until the curve matches the sketch underneath. For these edges, click on the point once to remove the handles. And don't worry if you were not happy with the path shape, you can always edit the curves by this pointer tool. Just click the point and change the position of the handles. And basically continue the same process until you have finished the shape. And for these drops, I use rectangle shape tool. Change the curve size and draw three shapes here. Then I combine these shapes by selecting all three of them. This quick tool appears on screen, and from this part you can access the unit. Just click on it to have a combined shape. Now you just need to set colors by using your color palettes. Finally, checking all my alignments, it's centered on the grid and ready for the last step. The final step is, of course, exporting your artwork. Go to File, Export, and select SVG. This vector format is the best format for digital icons. And that's it. We now have a fresh new icon. I hope that this was helpful, and if you like this video, then subscribe to the Vectornator channel for more design tips and information like this. Till the next time!